Flyboy.
This is a rebellion, isn't it?
I call it aggressive negotiations.
The garbage will do!
Welcome to this week's Trash Compactor podcast, Star Wars from a Certain Point of View. I'm Emcee.
I'm Sarah.
So things are going crazy right now, but also things are really good right now because, Sarah, why are things good right now?
Because there's Clone Wars and it's wonderful and amazing and I love it.
There is Clone Wars in the world again.
There is new Clone Wars in the world again.
And we just finished the first arc. There are three arcs of four episodes for these last 12 episodes. And we just finished the first four. And these are particularly good Clone Wars episodes because they actually focus on clones, which we like around here.
Just a little bit.
So this arc was called The Bad Batch. So we had The Bad Batch, A Distant Echo, On the Wings of Kiradax.
Kiradax.
And Unfinished Business. The last episode just aired on Friday, and we're going to talk about the entire arc, which is how we're going to be handling the Clone Wars episodes, because, I mean, like, it's very hard to talk about something when it's in the middle of a story.
And also because we have so many other things that we want to talk about, and everyone does weekly Clone Wars episodes. So
that is true, yeah.
We'll do arcly Clone Wars episodes.
I loved this.
I loved this, too. Have you seen the unfinished reels?
I have not, because I put it off and put it off and put it off. And when I was finally getting to the point where, oh, maybe I'll watch it, they announced the new episodes. And so then I was like, okay, then maybe I won't. I might track them down now.
Okay. I have seen them. So it was really fun to see the finished versions. Now, I haven't seen them in a while, so I probably don't remember everything, obviously. But it was really neat seeing what they added, how they changed it. They look so gorgeous, the new ones, I mean.
Yeah.
But I went into it knowing the story already.
I did not know the story. Because Clone Wars was something I did get into very late. And yeah, by the time I was starting to reach the end of my Clone Wars watch. I don't think we had gotten the announcement yet, but there were rumors, so I'm like, maybe I'll hold off for a little while.
Okay.
And there was a lot of Star Wars going on at the time, so it was kind of an easy thing to put off.
Mm-hmm.
I do have to say, like, I am interested in seeing the unfinished episodes, but just comparing these episodes to older Clone Wars episodes, they've really taken advantage of everything they've learned in the subsequent years.
Yes, these episodes are so gorgeous.
They're very pretty.
And just the detail they put into everything.
Yeah.
Some of it may have been there, but I certainly don't remember this much.
Well, I mean, like, in the time that since they've done previous Clone Wars, they've had four seasons of another show, right?
True.
And they also did Resistance, mm-hmm. which I'm not trying to denigrate Resistance, but I don't think what they learned from that could really translate to doing Clone Wars. But certainly Rebels was enough visually similar
mm-hmm.
that they could take what they learned from that.
All right, so let's talk about the story.
Yes, let's talk about the story.
Let's talk about the story.
So good.
So I just want to start by saying I bow down to D. Bradley Baker.
Oh my
because
god.
Because that first episode in particular is almost entirely him.
Yeah, there's like one or two characters who have like one or two lines, but the rest of it is just D. Bradley Baker talking to himself.
And I rewatched them today just to make sure everything was fresh in my head. And I watched a lot of that first episode with my eyes closed, and I could still tell the difference between the clones.
Nice. I can definitely understand that. Yeah, because he does put a different spin on all of them. And at one point, one of the clones imitates one of the other ones. Like, I forget, one of the Bad Batch imitates Rex.
Yes.
And it's not like he just sounds like Rex.
No, he still sounds like him, sounding like Rex.
That is just quite the talent there.
Yeah, like I said, I bow down to him. because that is an extraordinary accomplishment.
So, as we said earlier, that this is very much a clone episode. Like, it's the Clone Wars, and it's focusing on clones. And specifically, we get to know this group of clones that people colloquially call the Bad Batch there, which it's 99. What is it?
It's Clone Force 99.
Clone Force 99. I couldn't remember the I could remember the number, which is a callback, isn't it? To
yes, it's to the I don't remember the episode's name. It's the one where you see the clone troopers in training.
Yeah, and there is a clone trooper whose cloning did not go well.
He's basically a defective clone.
Yeah,
but he's there as like the trainer and support, and everyone looks up to him.
And if I recall correctly, he dies, doesn't he?
I think so, yeah.
But then we do get this group of clones who are quote-unquote defective, but they're defective in ways that are
useful.
Advantageous?
Yes.
They look very different than the typical Jango Fett, but you can still see, they still look like clones. They're just very different.
Mm-hmm.
Am I ashamed? Am I ever ashamed of anything? But I was just like, wow, I'm kind of into the Bad Batch.
I can understand that. No, they are really, really great. All right, so which of them's your favorite? I know, I just like drop it on you.
I think it's Tech. I like Tech a lot.
I like Tech. I honestly think I like Wrecker.
I like both of them for very different reasons. Tech I like because he's so very different from the usual clones, but no less, he's very useful. And Wrecker is just fun.
He's just fun. He's just violent and awesome and scared of heights.
Yeah.
And which is just so random, but it works.
I loved his childlike glee.
At destruction.
Yeah. Well, at the in the final episode when Anakin gives him the
the blowing
the
thing up to
the
set
base. Off the bombs. Yep. And he's just it's like this is the happiest day of my life.
I know. And I can understand that.
You too would like to blow things up.
Some days, yes.
Oh, we should be very careful. We don't want to get flags.
No, I do frequently threaten to set things on fire, so
I mean, this is the first time we've been introduced to them, but I know who each one of these guys are.
Yep, I feel like we've known them for years.
And seeing them interact with Rex, who, like, when you think of clones, you think of Rex. Like, mm-hmm. He's the perfect example of a clone, but that is to them a detriment.
Right.
Like, my head was going, like, with all of these thoughts about, you know, the ethics of cloning while watching this and the individuality. I mean, I tend to think about that kind of shit.
Yeah,
when we get clone episodes. Something that could probably take up an entire episode on its own.
We should do that at some point.
We'll put a note about that. That might actually make a really good Patreon episode. By the way, support our Patreon and you might be able to get an episode about the ethics of cloning.
Right. So I really, really loved Rex's insistence on Echo being alive.
Yeah.
And going after him. It's like, we don't leave our people behind.
Yeah, the whole leave no man behind. He's very loyal and just obviously he's felt guilt about what happened to these people, his brothers, for a long time. And he finally has the chance to rescue one of them. I actually think probably the strongest show of his affection for Echo did come at the very end where he's like, he saves them. But then he's like, he recognizes that Echo is on a different path now. And it's like, if you want to go with the Bad Batch, you know, you do what you feel you have to do. And you can see that he's so sad that he's not going to be fighting side by side with him.
He knows when he turns around that Echo is going back to the Bad Batch. But, oh, I love the animation of that moment.
Oh, it's really good.
Love, love, love. It's because Rex turns around and just he's the center of the screen and you don't see till it moves away what decision Echo has made. And even though everyone knows that he was going to decide to go, it's just seeing it was so gorgeous.
The animation on Echo was fantastic. You still recognized him as Echo, but you could just everything he had gone through was just Oh, it was heartbreaking just how emaciated they made him look.
But he's still a clone and he's still gonna stand up and fight for the Republic.
Now, here's a question that I am going to pose.
Okay.
With everything that happened to Echo, do you think that Echo would be one of the ones who could resist Order 66?
See, and I was wondering what the Bad Batch reacted to Order 66 anyway. I think they could, yes, resist it, I mean, but I don't know. And I would love to find out.
I just, like, all of the clones that I like, I just really wish, like, we're able to fight against Order 66. Even though I know Cody didn't.
Right.
And I like Cody, so.
Yeah, it's like, I just want to know what happens to all these people.
I mean, unfortunately, I don't know how much we're going to fight it. Though, I mean, like, can we set up like a group of clones like this and have them be the center point of an arc and then have them not turn up at like the Siege of Mandalore?
Sure.
I mean, I guess we could, but I would like to imagine, unless something terrible happens to them at the Siege of Mandalore, I feel like we'll probably, since like that was not done at all, mm-hmm. we might see them turn up again in that final arc.
We might. I mean, I also just hope we get, you know, either a book or a comic or some kind of continuation / conclusion to their story.
Well, I mean, we are getting the Clone Wars anthology.
Right. And then hopefully they'll be in there.
Yeah, I would think so. Because, I mean, they've already made quite the impact. And mm-hmm. I mean, like, that even during, like, people were very excited to have this animated finally, because with the original unfinished stuff, people really liked the Bad Batch.
Right.
Oh, man, there's just...
I know. Okay, so the other thing we need to talk about in these episodes, other than the clones, is Anakin and Obi-Wan.
Yes, 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 yes.
Yes.
Okay, first of all, on a scale of 1 to 10, how bad are Padme and Anakin at being secret married?
17.
I was going to go with about 9,000.
Yeah, they're terrible. They are absolutely terrible at it.
Yeah, I think, like, we've got confirmation now that Obi-Wan might not know the extent of it, but he certainly knows that they're
together.
Yeah. And also, how stupid is Anakin? Where, like, Padme, with this, like, little pouching belly, touching it the entire time.
Yeah.
And he's just like, not like, hey Padme, why are you standing like that? You've never stood like that before.
But you know what? I thought it would be more like intrusive seeing it, but it's not. It's subtle once you actually see it in the episode.
It is subtle, and I think they did it really well, but I do chalk that up to Anakin being a little bit thick.
Yeah, Anakin's a little bit of an idiot.
Anakin's a little bit thick, and so is Padme right now.
Yeah, Rex is a terrible liar.
That's so endearing, because, like, that's just who Rex is. He's just so goddamn honorable that mm-hmm. he can't lie about anything.
Not a thing. But it's adorable.
It is.
But yeah, it's when I realized that Obi-Wan knew. I just kind of went, that is amazing. It just says so much about his character, too.
I mean, that's something else that I would like covered in the anthology. Like, what are Obi-Wan's feelings about it? Like, why doesn't he go to the council about it? Because yes, he loves Anakin, but Anakin is breaking the...
everything?
Yes, every single role that they have. Is it just his love for Anakin? Is it because he thinks that there are more important things that they're doing? There's just so much. I want to be in Obi-Wan's head.
Yeah.
I mean, I usually want to be in Obi-Wan's
head. I know. I was just trying to figure out how to answer that.
Oh, the end of this arc with Anakin. I believe I actually said to my screen, hello, Darth Vader.
That too.
Anakin was... I can't remember the name of the guy that he was going up against, but, you know, he's like, you know, Dooku will kill me. And, like, you can see it in Anakin's eyes. He's like, yeah, I'll kill you first.
Mm-hmm. Well, Anakin's always been a bit with potential for darkness.
It's always been there. I don't want to say what he did isn't wrong, because it definitely is wrong, mm-hmm. and it was definitely the dark side, but...
Understandable.
Yes. I mean, he did it for noble reasons. And mm-hmm. I mean, I guess that's why they say that the road to hell is paved with good intentions.
Yes.
I enjoyed Mace Windu.
I did too.
I liked him going up against the droids and basically, you know, telling him, this is how many droids I've killed, which is such a, you know, that's such a Mace Windu thing to do, to know exactly how many droids he's taken out.
Yep.
But, like, giving them the chance to, like, lay down their arms and be reprogrammed, and it's just, like, a total no-sell.
Yeah, basically.
And then Obi-Wan being, I don't think that worked. Or it was a good effort. You sassy bitch, Obi-Wan.
He is so sarcastic in this arc.
Yes.
It's great. I think sarcastic Obi-Wan is my favorite Obi.
Oh, yeah. Definitely. Yeah. That is something that we didn't really get to see once he had matured into Alec Guinness.
Yeah, no, then he was just a little bitchy. There's a better word for that, but I'm not coming up with it.
It works. So, what was your favorite part of this?
Honestly, I think it was Anakin trying to drag Rex over to guard the door. It's just like whisper, 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 nudge, nudge, nudge. Come on, you know that thing. What thing? That thing. It's just, it was so very, it said so much about both of their characters.
I feel like Rex has had that job a lot.
Oh yeah, no, it was definitely not the first time that had happened.
I feel like sometimes he's had that job when Padme is actually there.
That too.
Which, poor Rex.
Poor Rex.
I honestly think my favorite bit is the end when Rex lets Echo go.
Okay.
That was such a strong moment. There was just, you know, a little teary.
Yeah, it's a goosebump moment.
So is there anything else we want to say about
it? Oh, I could probably keep on going, but then I'm just going to start repeating myself.
Is there anything you didn't really like?
Not a thing. No, seriously. I think it was just so wonderful.
I figured that would be the answer. And actually, I can't really come up with anything that really stood out to me that I disliked. I'm so happy that we've got Clone Wars back. I am so happy that we got an arc about the clones, because I love me some clones.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it just, I am so looking forward to seeing the rest of these episodes. And at the same time, also being a bit sad that we only have 8 episodes left.
I know, but it's still 8 more episodes than we ever thought we would get more.
That is very true. Very, very true. So I think that brings us to the end of this. You know, we'll be back in another 4 weeks to talk about the next arc. And the next arc is Ahsoka, yes?
Yes, the next arc is Ahsoka in the Underworld, or whatever it's called.
The lower levels of Coruscant.
Ahsoka in the Underworld.
Which should be a lot of fun. This is a completely original arc, yes?
Yes. The next 2 arcs are both things that I believe have been talked about at various conventions, but none of it is stories we have seen yet.
The Siege of Mandalore, I feel like we know more about than this next arc that's coming up. This next one is a bit more mysterious.
Yes.
We just know that it's going to bridge the gap between Ahsoka leaving the Jedi Order and Ahsoka being in the Siege of Mandalore.
Right.
Which, there's going to be some big changes in her character. So I'm very much looking forward to that, because I love me some Ahsoka.
Yes.
Until our next Clone Wars episode, we'll be talking about a lot of other stuff in the Star Wars universe. So tell us what you thought about the Bad Batch episodes. You can reach us at SW Trash Podcast on Twitter. And I'm MC Frotus on Twitter.
I am Murnell.
You can also find us on Facebook, Tumblr, and YouTube at Trash Compactor Podcast. And please, if you like what we do, support us on Patreon. We're Trash Compactor Podcast over there. We are putting out exclusive episodes, and we would love to do more of them. Like we said earlier, we'd love to do an episode about the morality of cloning. Seriously, now that we've got that idea in my head, I'm like, I really want to do that.
Me too.
So please go over there, support us so that we can keep doing what we're doing. Supporting us will help with hosting and various other things that we need to keep the podcast going. So until next time, may the Force be with you.
Always.